Today, Amwal-Mag welcomes Adel Mardini, founder and CEO of Jetex, a leading general aviation trip support company based in Dubai. It has a special focus on private aviation and an extensive global network operating around 30 FBOs and ground handling stations in multiple countries from Brazil to now Singapore. Adel, welcome. Thank you for joining us today.
Thank you for having us.
So, Adel, first, 2020 has been a challenging year for the aviation sector, yet you've announced in the last quarter a new FBO station for you in Singapore. So what do you see that others don't?
For us, what happened in 2020, it's opportunity. Unfortunately, it was not good opportunity for the commercial airlines because they keep suffering. And as you know, like IATA released a statement that every single minute, commercial airlines losing $300,000. And the commercial airlines will keep suffering for the coming 3 to 5 years. Because what happening, it's not only health crisis, it's financial crisis. We remember very well the financial crisis 2008, but now we consider this one financial crisis, especially for the aviation. And you know, mainly aviation and the hospitality sector, which is like the most sector which affect from this pandemic. For us, we see a lot of people shifting from first and business class coming to private jet. We see 70% of our customers and new customer. We did not see these names before. And this is like an indication about the private jet. Flying a private jet before was accessory and now became necessary. And this is the difference before the pandemic and before after the pandemic. We took 2020 year as a year for preparation for making more progress in our portfolio. And this is why in the last quarter of this year, we announced about first location in Asia Pacific, which is Singapore. Singapore, you know, as you know, is a hub for the business aviation in Asia. And it's a business center for the real estate, for the banking system, for all the stuff in Asia Pacific. So we select Singapore, same like how we select Dubai, because Dubai is a hub of Middle East and North Africa and Middle East and the Arabian area, same like for Singapore. And we expect the business will go back quickly to Singapore. And the biggest indication about the strength of position of Singapore, that World Economic Forum choose Singapore to host Davos Forum during the month of May, this 2021. And this is the first time they move Davos from Zurich to Singapore. And this house, Singapore, is very strong location. And we are so lucky to be there during this forum in order to welcome and hand it all over our customers.
So is this a general trend for you to continue developing within Asia, which seem to be a missing link within your global network?
This is our first location there, and we are targeted to add two more locations in Asia Pacific by 2021. We see big potential market in Asia. We see it's still emerging market there, especially for like four countries. We are talking about Thailand, Vietnam, Indonesia, and Philippines. These four countries, we believe, like will see big growth in the coming 5 years, because we see like a lot of, especially in Indonesia, a lot of new owner coming to the industry, and they are flying around Asia. And all of them consider Singapore as a hub for them, especially for the banking system.
And so you've started basically as an FBO, but you've developed other activities. Today, yeah. Could you tell more about these activities, and also for some of our viewers, how the mechanism work within private aviation and the importance of high quality level FBOs in terms of clientele and selection and the competition within the landscape?
Jetex is a platform. It's not only for the FBO or private jet terminal. We are doing like logistic and support. We are doing private concierge. We are exclusive dealer for Honda Jet for our region. It's not only limited for certain type of the business. Anything related to the business aviation is our specials, our bread and butter, how we arrange the flight for the business owner smoothly without hustle and seamless experience. This is what we are doing. We deliver exceptional experience to our customer. which is they can touch, they can be connected to Jetex all the time. And the business, in business aviation is very is unusual to build a brand in the business aviation. Jetex came and built the brand in this industry in order for all the high individual people to be connected to this brand. And again, during the pandemic, we created a new team inside the company to take care about the cargo section, because we found a big demand for the cargo. And because of the platform and the know-how that we have, it was very easy for us to create this team, which is like the cargo one. And this now, the team is working now for the vaccine. And we start doing a lot of arrangement for the moving vaccine from country to country. So Jetex is not only related, related to the business aviation or the FBO, no. We are a platform in the aviation industry, and we are keep expanding, and we have big potential to grow because we build a strong platform for the past 15 years.
And in terms of connectivity between the Middle East and Europe and Asia, in which vertical, in which of these different sectors that you are developing in, you see the biggest potential in the Middle East and globally?
Look, we believe clearly Africa and Asia Pacific, this is like the place that is coming to grow in the coming future, in addition to Latin America. You know, 60% of the private jet ticket in US, 27% in Europe, which means this area is like fully of like experts people. But we see the newcomer, a new generation of the people who like, especially after the pandemic, are going to using the private jet in this new area, which is Africa, and in Africa, Asia, and Latin America. And this area that we are going to focus for the coming 5 years.
And in all industries are starting to be disrupted by innovation, by startups. How is it happening within the private aviation? We've seen some examples of startups that try to make, let's say, private aviation available on a single leg, but they didn't go very well. Where do you see innovation coming in private aviation? And I know that Jetex was one of the first to launch really an app that connected their users and their customers throughout their experience. So how do you see technology changing private aviation in the coming future?
Look, for us, we see, especially again during the pandemic or after the pandemic, I see mainly the people will start sharing the private jet. I see a couple of families coming in one private jet, and sometimes they don't know each other. So they just like, I will not say they are buying seat from the airplane operator, but they are sharing the seat and sharing the cost. We have a couple of example flight going to Beirut with like 10 like family of 10 people, they share the cost, like $30,000, everyone be like $3,000 or $4,000, and they share the cost. Same as the flying in private, Emirates Airlines first class. So I believe that for the coming 3 to 5 years, the people will share the airplane. I believe that the people who the user of the private jet will be increasing. I believe the new technology and the application which make it the flying a private jet accessible for a lot of people. This is will be the headlines for the coming 3 to 5 years for the private aviation business. And we see all the people get to know how it's easy for them to fly in private aviation.
If you take your sector, how do you see also with Honda Jet, the development and the opportunities in Jetex becoming larger in this sector? Or is it an exclusive relationship with Honda Jet? How do you see developing this segment within your activity?
To be honest with you, before the pandemic, we found difficulty promoting Honda Jet for the market, because it's, first of all, it's a new product for the industry, number one. Number two, it's because of the range of the airplane. But now during this pandemic, and since like third quarter of 2020 till today, we are almost on a weekly basis, we are receiving a new inquiry, a new request for Honda Jet, because the people want to fly the aircraft by themselves. And this is again, okay, the people look now for more to be privacy and to be more in a way in a healthy environment. This is why they are looking for Honda Jet now seriously as a solution, especially for the region. If you want to fly Dubai Riyadh, Dubai Muscat, Dubai Kuwait, this is something which like easy. If you have a license, you can fly it by this aircraft. And we see right now we have two Honda Jet in our terminal here, which for the passenger who brought this aircraft with them from Europe. But this family moved from Europe to be based in Dubai, and they are move their airplane with them to fly in this region.
Interesting. And so we've also seen that was pre-pandemic, but we've seen like major hotel companies like Four Seasons move into the private jet. We've seen Ritz-Carlton move into the yacht. For you and the platform, and you're well known for the high level quality service that you provide, could Jetex move into another segment such as yachting or hotels in the future? You mentioned opportunities. Is this something that you would consider?
Again, Jetex is a platform. We don't name the when the, our passenger is a guest. When you are in the commercial airport, you are clearly in shopping mall. When you are in Jetex, you are on five-star hotel. This is our concept. So we believe like Jetex on the land side, we are a private five-star hotel. In the on the ramp side, we are aviation company. So we are mixed between hospitality and aviation. This is how we see ourselves. So to answer the question, yes, we have a big potential to grow because we are investing a lot in our brand, and all the customers that are flying with Jetex, they know what Jetex, what the level of the service that Jetex present to them. So moving to, again, to more on the hospitality, yes, this is our intention and this is our target for the coming years.
Just to conclude, I mean, we're in this current period where businesses are suffering and they try to find a way. You've built your business, you've started from scratch. So I'd love you to, as an inspiration to young entrepreneurs that might be doubting themselves today, just to tell your story and how it went through, because I think it's a wonderful story.
It's long. When I started this business, I started as a driver, driving the crew and the passenger from the airport to the airplane. And this is something which is like, I'm so proud about it, because this is when and where I got my experience. And without this experience that I got, like 15, 20 years ago, I will not reach what I reach today. I had a dream and I achieved this dream. And if you ask me, are you still having to looking for more? Yes, for sure, because we keep learning. And we are living in Dubai, the city which like all the time is looking for more and more to be creative. And this is something push us to be all the time in the leading position. So when I started this business like early 2005, before I was driving the crew, this gave me the experience about the actual requirement of the private jet owner, actual requirement of the crew. And this experience give me what I have today. Still till today, regardless how much experience I got, but this is something which is like, it was my major tools that I use to reach what I reach today. Because in the end, the bank is fully of money, but you need someone to manage this money. So I got what I got today, and I ask everyone to build a dream. And if anyone has no dream, let's have a dream. And trust me, if you have like the tools and if you have the intention to do it, you can achieve it. And this is what happened for me.
Adel, thank you so much. These are very inspiring words, especially in these troubled times. And I think that the innovation that you showed and the opportunity that you see in time of crisis is a lesson for many entrepreneurs in our region. Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you very much. Thank you.